Hello, folks of YouTube. Welcome back to Turnabout Samurai, the third episode of Ace Attorney, the first one. It's episode 3, Turnabout Samurai. And it's October 18th, 10 a.m., District Court, courtroom number 4. We are ready. It's Edgeworth again. Okay. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor. The defense is ready, Your Honor. Very well, Mr. Edgeworth, your opening statement, please. The prosecution will show the court that at 2:30 p.m. on October 15, the defendant, Mr. Will Powers, killed fellow actor Jack Hammer in Studio One of Global Studios. It is impossible for anyone else to have committed this heinous crime. Evidence presented during the trial will all point to this fact. I see. Very well, I would like to move on to some testimony. Mr. Edgeworth, the prosecution may call us for his witness. Very well, I call a most familiar face, Detective Gumshoe, to the stand. Shout out, Gumshoe. Detective, if you would briefly describe this case to the court. Yes, sir. I'll explain with the guide map here. Understand this case, it's important to grasp the layout of the studio, see? This here is the employee area. We still haven't decided on the Gumshoe accent, we gotta work on that. I know it's Brooklyn. In my heart, I know he has a thick Brooklyn accent, but I can't do it. Actors did a run-through of their action scenes during the morning here. This is the main gate to the studios. The security lady that works at the studios was here at 1 p.m. on that day. Past the security station, there is a gate, see? Past that are the studios. And here it is, Studio 1. This is the scene of the murder where the body was found. Now, on the day of the murder, October 15th, there were only 3 people here. The victim, Jack Hammer, the defendant, Will Powers, and the young woman, the production assistant. We still haven't gotten her name. Officially, I think it said she was named Penny. All the production staff were in the employee area until noon. Then after lunch, the victim, Jack Hammer, went to Studio 1. Right after that, at 1 p.m., the security lady got to the guard station. Now jumping to later that day, 5 p.m. Production staff came to Studio 1 to perform a rehearsal. Needless to say, the rehearsal was cancelled. After they found Jack Hammer's body, the time of death was 2:30 p.m. The samurai spear found lodged in the victim's chest was the murder weapon. That's the case in brief. Anyone like to hear that again? Nah, we got it. I think I can probably remember that. So the murder weapon was a spear. How medieval. Okay, samurai spear added to the court record. Your Honor, this case is quite simple if you ask one question. And that question is, what did the security lady at the guard station see? Understood. Let's call the security officer to the stand. Okay, here she is. She's gonna be easy to mess around with because she's very mad. She's so mad all the time. Will the witness declare her name? Oh my god. One of the sprites of all time. My, aren't you a handsome fellow? I'm afraid I'm a bit flustered. Your name, please. Oh dearie, no need for you to be embarrassed. Just call me Grandma. Your name, please. Edgeworth is a bit of trouble getting his witnesses to say their names. I wonder why that is. It'd be funny if it was just like a bit, but I'm curious if there's like more to it than that. Wendy Oldbag, dearie. That can't be her name. Her name can't be Oldbag. There's no way. So it's funny, Grandma's probably name, but even though I was just like, Oldbag, it's still going to be funny just because my name can you believe it? There's this boy, the Captain Chester Trouble Junior High, when he called me an Oldbag, watch crack and crack as I crushed him, you see? Thank you. Objection, I object to the witness's talkativeness. Objection sustained. The witness will refrain from rambling on the stand. I was getting to the good part, dearie. Perhaps we can get to the testimony. Now, the witness was stationed at the main gate on the day of the murder, correct? Yes, I was. And to get to the scene of the murder, well, someone would have had to crawl past the gate, I believe. I'm sorry. You know your stuff, dearie. You may begin your testimony. She sure is one hell of an old bag. Yo, what's up, Waffles? How's it going? Welcome in. How are you tonight? Here we go. the account of one, she actually named Oldbag. On the day of the murder, I arrived at the guard station at 1 p.m. Poor old Hammer and the rest had been doing a run through there since the morning. I had some errands to run that morning. Anyway, it was 1 o'clock when I got to the guard station. At the main gate from then until 5. Now, the murder happened at 2:30 p.m., right? Interesting to me because a certain man walked by right by me at 2 p.m. It was Powers, the man right there, and he was heading toward the studio. Objection. You saw the defendant then? Very well. Let's begin the cross-examination. Mr. Wright's... Oh, Maya's theme. Yes. That was so weird, by the way. The whole Maya thing. Yes, Your Honor. All right, here we go. Let's just roast her immediately. Get roasted. Objection. Let me get this straight, Oldbag, or Ms. Oldbag. You've been saying since yesterday that you saw Mr. Powers, correct? But you're talking about the man in this photo, aren't you? Just a moment, Mr. Wright. Let me see that photo. It's very clearly an ill-fitting costume. What is this exactly? None other than the Steel Samurai, defender of Neo Old Tokyo. Ms. Oldbag. Is this the Mr. Powers that you saw? Of course! Don't your mama teach me any sense, Sonny? Anyone can plainly see that's Powers, right? No, they can't! Edgeworth is losing it. I wonder. True, Mr. Powers does play the role of the Steel Samurai. But that doesn't mean Powers is the Steel Samurai. I like her trapezoidal mouth there. I know that. I wasn't born yesterday. No one in this court is accusing you of that, Ms. Witness. Having trouble calling her Oldbag, apparently. Fair enough. However, you do not have proof the person in this photo is Mr. Will Powers, do you? Nosy old man. That's the judge. What goes on in these courtrooms? Of course I have proof. What? Huh? Even Edgeworth is surprised? Edgeworth is fun this time. The prosecution would like to ask the witness. Please make known all the information in your possession ahead of time. How was I to know everyone would be so nosy? You should be ashamed, all of you. It's a courtroom. What are you talking about? Anyway, I showed that photo of the young detective. He told me this isn't any good as evidence, pal. He's right. He didn't even give it a second look. Wow, old Woodbag has even left Edward speechless. She's good. Let's hear about your proof, then. Okay, here we go. Testimony round two. Oh boy, man of the photo. Here we go. I never say anything I don't mean, mind you. That morning, during the run-through of the action scene, I saw Powers trip and fall. He broke one of the props. It was a big mess. Apparently, he sprained his ankle pretty bad. Now look at that picture. You can see he's dragging his leg. See? Clear as day. So I knew it was Powers. Happy? But that doesn't prove anything. So he had sprained his ankle. Very well, Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness. She's gotta be hiding something. I'll press her until she squeals. Alright, here we go. We're just gonna push Q a bunch of times. Be funny. This will probably be funny to press around this. Whippersnapper. Hey, I haven't said anything yet. I'll have you know, I'm not pointing fingers at anyone behind their backs. Everything I've said is on the straight and narrow. Yup and up. Youth today always whine about each other, pointing fingers, and only want to cry. Mr. Wright, please, for all our sakes, try not to upset the witness. I think Edgeworth has met his match. True. The action scene. Yep, I saw Powers trip and fall. Broke one of the props. Was a big mess. Apparently, he sprained his ankle pretty bad. Let's see. What do we have here? Anything else? Anything else we got? Hold it. Was Mr. Power's ankle badly sprained? Not so bad that he couldn't walk around. He went to his dressing room to rest up after lunch. Thus the nap. Anyway, I saw him dragging his foot when he walked. Dragging his foot, okay. That's good information. You can see you dragging his legs. See? Clear as day. No. Are you absolutely sure? Let's look at the picture again. No, this is ill-fitting. There's both legs. So he was walking strangely because he was injured. It does look like he was dragging his foot. See? And you didn't trust me, whippersnapper. What? I'm very confused. He broke a prop? Sure did. His own samurai spear. The samurai spear? The murder weapon? Luckily, I was there with my duct tape to fix it. This strikes me as a significant detail. Better write this down in the court record. Samurai spear updated in the court record. Interesting. Okay. That was important. I'm glad we picked that up. Who was present at the run-through? Well, let's see. There was Powers, he's a steel samurai, and then poor old Hammer, the evil magistrate, and me. And what exactly were you doing? Observing, just observing. What about the assistant? Oh, she was off doing backdrops around and such. So she didn't see the run-through then. Okay, interesting. Trip and fall? Yes, the thing, he's supposed to be the steel samurai. What a laugh. Powers sprained his ankle. Helped make it better for him, of course. You helped make it better? Objection, you're old. L. Too old. Touch grass. Objection. I kissed it where it hurt. Let's just skip over that part, shall we? Where was the assistant then? Oh, her? She was cleaning up backdrops, I think. She didn't know what powers his ankle. I think we've heard enough. Haven't we, Your Honor? Well, there is one thing that bothers me, which is... Where is the steel samurai costume now? Actually, well, we couldn't find it. We're looking, though. Anyway, that's not important. The witness did see the steel samurai, yes? And it is clear the person in the steel samurai suit was Mr. Will Powers. I suppose that's right. Are you sure you're sure, Your Honor? Hold it right there. We keep talking possibilities, but we have to read this photo shows the steel samurai. Nowhere in this photo can you see Mr. Will Powers. The defense has a point. I also wonder if someone else not caught on camera could have killed Mr. Hammer. We have to consider that possibility also. Then allow me to remove that doubt from your mind, Your Honor. And judge having brain cells? Absolutely no shot. Will the witness continue her testimony, please? No need to ask twice. Oh my god. The witnesses are always so much. Okay, here we go. The time of poor Hammer's death was 2:30 p.m., true? Only person I saw go to the studio before them was Will Powers. No one else went there. If they had, I would have seen him. That was the testimony? So if no one else went to the studio, then it would have to be the steel samurai who did it. Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness. Alright, let's see what we got. Alright, time for Hammer's death was 2:30 p.m., true? That sounds true to me. Yep, that sounds good. We like that. Only person I saw go to the studio before them was Will Powers. Press. Are you absolutely sure? Oh, quite, Sonny. No one's suspicious looking past by at all. Nobody suspicious looking? Right. No one else went there. One more time. What about before you got to the guard station? Before 1 p.m.? Well, Edwin was in the employee area before then, and I locked the main gate so no one could get in. Not to mention. If they had, I would have seen him. Hold it. Are you sure?
Objection!
The witness has answered the question. Okay. Okay, yep. That's the right sucker. You let him have it, edgy boy. Edgy boy? Well, Windbag sure has balls in the bowl. You know what I mean. Well, Windbag said we'd be skipping over important details after all, or for that matter, entirely forgetting them. How convenient. If you'd look forward to, perhaps? We gotta loop back to this? That is true. I guess we can hit her with the, this is not Will Powers. Hold on. Look at this photograph one more time. This photo was taken by the camera at the gate for the studios, correct? Yes, sirree, sonny. So, whenever anyone passes by here, it automatically takes a picture. And here I thought you'd know your head from a hole in the ground. Right. Anyway. It's also true that the computer in the guard station records all security cam data. Oh, you know, if you wanted to work at the studio, we might have an opening. That very computer printed out this photo. Note that on the back of the photo are printed the words, October 15th, 2 p.m., photo number 2. Even I know that means it was taken on 2 p.m. October 15th. Really, Sonny? Actually, I knew that too. You should be here's the bit at the end where it says, photo number 2. Photo number 2? The computer only held data for one photo on that day. Don't you think that's odd? Shouldn't this photo be photo number 1 if it really was the only photo? Uh-oh, busted. Order, order. Please tell the court what you mean by this, Mr. Wright. Actually, that's what I want to ask the witness. This evidence shows that not one, but two people went to the studio that day. Yet there is only data for one of the photos. Who could have erased the data for the other photo? Only someone with access. The security lady herself. Eh? You watch your mouth, whippersnapper. The only person I saw that day was Will Powers. If photo one's so good, but the camera on the gate fired twice, that means two people went by. Well, yes, that was what it would seem to mean. Can the witness explain this to the courts? I don't understand these newfangled computer things. Hey, edgy boy, help! Huh? Believe me, I want to, but I don't know what this means either. Some help you are. You're a whippersnapper, too. Whippersnapper? Something the matter, Ms. Oldbag. Ah, that's right. I just remembered something. Let me guess. Someone else passed by the gates? Someone other than the Steel Samurai? Well, yes, I suppose you could put it that way. Incredible. I see. Your testimony, please. Here we go. Finally. Every day after I finish my guard duties, I have one more important job to do. I go through the photos recorded on the security computer and check them. As for any photos that aren't suspicious looking, you see. Oh, no, thank you. Now I remember throwing out one photo that day. Oh my god. Ms. Oldbag, this is the first I've heard of this. Well, of course, Sonny. I only just remembered it. Right. Anyway, Mr. Wright, please begin the cross-examination. Well, I'd say this was a turn to the unexpected, but I kind of expected this. True. Agreed. Here we go. Okay, that's fair enough. We take those. Those are the photos recorded on the computer. Yo, what's up, Green Raven? How's it going? Welcome in. It's so much fun so far. I'm having a blast. Okay. Sure. More details, please. How many photos are there usually? On a day when we're open to the public, you get more than 500 people. But on filming days and rehearsal days, well, we don't have much money. We never get more than 50, and that's a big day. Do you back up all the security camera data? Well, they keep telling me to, yes, but those computers are just so frustrating. Oh dear, okay. They aren't suspicious looking. Alright, what does that even mean? How exactly do you determine what isn't suspicious looking? Oh, you can tell by looking at the faces, for the most part. For the most part? This is a murder trial, Ms. Oldbag. Oh, I didn't touch that suspicious-looking Phil Powers' photo, did I? I think she's missing the point. She is. I can't believe this. Well, who in the heck was in that photo you erased? A fanboy. Fanboy? Steel Samurai fanboys. Real freaks, if you ask me. The information that rehearsals from gosh knows where. They're always hanging about. One was there that day. Wait a second. Didn't you just say no one else could get in? It's infuriating how many times the witnesses are like, oh, I'm like 1000% sure this is what happened. 5 minutes passed. Oh, you mean I totally forgot. I didn't mean I was like 100% sure. I locked the main gate so no one could get in. Those were your words. Well, if you must know, there's a drain that goes into the employee area. Oh my god, she knew about it. The grate's been loose for a while. It leads outside and, well, that's where they come in. They come through the drain? I told you they were freaks. Oh, and... oh, east! I thought you said west. And... they're kids, children, whippersnappers. Kids? So in the photo that you erased, it was a boy, probably second or third grade. What? Order. Let me get this straight. You saw two people pass by the gate on their way to the studios that day. One was a steel samurai dragging his leg. The other was a boy who looked to be about in second or third grade. Oh yes, well, we see this type there every day. Can't stop him. Can't catch him. A boy in second or third grade? I assume it'd be hard, if not impossible, for a young boy to wield the samurai spear. Impossible, I think. It's quite heavy. Right, as I said, I didn't pay much mind. That's why I erased the data. Nick? What's going on? I mean, the boy was there. That makes him a suspect. Yeah, and they're already trying to unsuspect him. Or unsuspect? Something wrong there. This court will take a 5-minute recess. Really? I want the defense and the prosecution to consider this new information, and no forgetting vital information this time. Okay, recess time. Let's go. Alright. 18th. That was the 10th. Okay, never mind. It was 10 a.m., right? Okay. Alright, here we go. Mr. Powers? Yes? Tell me straight. Were you really in your dressing room? You didn't go to the studio. I didn't go to the studio. I was sleeping, honest. So who was the Steel Samurai in the security photo? How should I know? The Steel Samurai costume was off in the corner of the dressing room. Anyone could have walked in and taken it, really. What? You should take better care of that stuff. I couldn't imagine anyone want to steal a Steel Samurai costume, so where does this leave me? Doesn't look good. You're the only likely suspect right now. Nick, what are we gonna do? First, we play for more time. We'll start targeting someone else that could conceivably have done this. Right. It'll take them so long to shoot us down that we can get another day. Right. But if we pick the wrong person, we might lose on the spot. You don't sound very optimistic. I'm not optimistic at all, actually. Hey, Nick, it's time. Okay, let's go. Ugh. What does that mean? Please don't sigh like that. Oh, poor Will Powers. He's a gentle giant. He's kind of doofy. He's just here to do his job. Court will now reconvene for the trial of Mr. Will Powers. Oops. Mr. Edgeworth, will you present the prosecution's thoughts on this matter? The prosecution's thoughts are simple. Nothing has changed. For the person who went to the studios is a boy of roughly 10 years of age. The photo we do have may not be hard evidence. But there is still no one else that could have committed this crime. Yeah. Will Powers. I don't think anybody would love to have this prop from a popular show. That'd be weird. I call for a verdict of guilty for the defendant, Mr. Will Powers. Very well, Mr. Wright, your thoughts? The defense disagrees with the prosecution's claim. There is another person who could have committed this crime. Order. Interesting. Let us hear what you have in mind. However, be aware this court does not look kindly on accusing the innocent. In this court? You're telling me you don't... Insane. If you accuse someone who's obviously innocent, you'll be penalized. Right. Great. Stakes weren't high enough. So, who was this person other than Mr. Powers that could have committed murder? I mean, this is the currently, like, the most obvious. We have no tracking on her. She was just sort of gone all day. And I don't want to accuse her, because she seems nice and helpful. But there's, like, she's the only person. Like, they dismissed the grade school boy out of hand. So it could be the grade school boy. Or it could be, like, a small adult. She's like totally untracked, so. We don't accuse the innocent in this court, isn't that right, Mr. Edgeworth? The steel costume samurai costume is in his dressing room. She stole it, and doing so, she became the steel samurai. So you're saying the steel samurai in the picture is really the assistant? That's correct, Your Honor. Objection. If you're serious, you've got guts, Mr. Rice. Remember the photo? Wasn't the steel samurai a little lame? He was dragging his foot. Oh, bad feeling time. This one's weird, because, like, the photo to me looks very obviously like somebody is wearing pants that are too long, not like someone's dragging their foot. And if the assistant is just shorter than the huge man that Will Powers is, that all checks out suddenly. Oh, her? She was cleaning up backdrops, I think. The assistant knew nothing of Mr. Powers' injury. She could look at the Steel Samurai look with that costume. She couldn't walk the Steel Samurai walk. She wouldn't have limped. Ugh. Kind of takes the legs out from under that case. Mr. Wright, I'm afraid I had to penalize you as I warned. Oops. Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Maybe we move on, Mr. Wright. One more chance, please. Very well. Well, it's a 50-50, folks. Because the thing is, like, it could have been... They really dismissed the grade school boy out of hand. They're really like, oh, yeah. It can't have been him. So if I go, oh, it was him, they'd be like, oh, no, hello, he's 10. So I think our best shot is the security lady. It was the security lady, Wendy Oldbag. Who? Steel Samurai is dragging his leg in this picture. This means whoever's in the suit knew about that morning's injury. Maybe because they had been watching the action scene run through. Only one person other than Powers and Hammer who knew about the injury. Security lady, Oldbag. What? Whippersnapper. Not perfect, but we take those. Order, order. Is this true, Oldbag? Oldbag, that's Ms. Oldbag to you. Ms. Oldbag was standing guard at one of the main gates. She was by herself. In other words, she has no alibi. She could have briefly let the poser steal the Steel Samurai costume and slipped in the studio on the scene of the murder. Why would she go through the trouble of wearing the Steel Samurai costume? Simple, Your Honor. She knew the camera at the gate would take her picture. If she was in his costume, she could put the finger in Mr. Powers. I see. Excellent deductive reasoning, Mr. Wright. Oh yeah, right here. Sherlock Holmes 2, baby. Shouldn't that be Herlock Sholmes? That's odd. Isn't this the part where Edgeworth pounces? Doesn't he usually jump up with an objection and some new damning evidence? Well, Mr. Edgeworth, does the prosecution have an opinion on this matter? The prosecution has no meaningful objections at this time. What? What's that supposed to mean? Oh, so you all think I did it, is that it? Edgy boy, don't just to do something. What's my move? Maybe now I can't take this the whole way. Press further or give Granny a break? I don't know. That's interesting. Going in for the kill seems a little unwise. Yeah, Edward just hates her. Yeah, extremely fair. If we... Well, let's think about what could happen. If we press further, that could give Edward an opportunity if we, like, go get a little too gung-ho and we're like, yeah, she must have killed him. Edward's like, oh, isn't the defense looking a little suspicious here? Giving her a break... could be wise in that regard. On the other hand, if Edward really has nothing right now, pushing is good. Pushing is really good. We didn't come here to not win the case. The very same reasoning that makes Mr. Power the suspect in this case can be used to count down on Miss Oldbag's actions on that day. But why would I do something so horrible to poor Hammer? You forget that Mr. Power lacks a clear motive too. Indeed. That did it. No, Windbag's one of the suspects. Hard feelings, I hope. Wait just a minute. What about the other person who went to the studio? The boy! The one whose photo I erased. Only a grade school, though, as you said. Second or third grade, was it? That doesn't matter. When I was that age, I could pin my old man in 10 seconds, tops. Your thoughts, Mr. Wright? Yeah, good point, Raven, for sure, for sure. And that's, you know, I think that's the case often with, like, any sort of VN or text adventure game like this, where, like, you know, very similarly, it can't always work out. That boy is not the killer. What? How can you be so sure? Oh, is it be nice to the kids and mean to yell this day? Whippersnapper. I have proof. Proof? Indeed. Let's see this proof, Mr. Wright. You have proof that shows the boy could not have committed this murder? It would, like, have to be this? It's either the spear or the card key. Much like with the options, right? Like, I can see where they, like, if we're going to allege that the grade schooler couldn't have done this because it's too heavy, right? We could do that. Or due to the break, if the spear was mended right away, then yeah, sure. Otherwise, though, how would this guy have gotten the spear? The card key, though, would be the issue, right? Because we found this on the side. We need a card key to get into Studio One. It's got to be one of those two. Because this doesn't help us at all. Let's go card key. The scene of the murder, as we all know, was Studio One. However, you need a card key to enter Studio One. How could a boy with no formal relation to the studios have a card key? I see. Well, would the witness care to comment on this? The windbag, speechless. This has got to be a first. We had a MRF 2. What was it? ERP and ERP? It was ERP and URP. Very well. This court will suspend proceedings on the current trial for today. Mr. Edgeworth, please find out more about your witness, Miss Windy... what was her name? Something old bag, Your Honor. And the prosecution will look further into this old bag before we continue. That is all. This court is adjourned. Okay! Got through that unscathed. Wait a second. I'm not gonna just sit here while you're barking up the wrong tree. Me? Oh, the spear is valid too? Okay, that's good to know. Okay. I'm talking. Oh, great. Stop the presses. The windbag wants to talk. Ms. Oldbag, what is this all about? Have you omitted something from your testimony? Actually, he must know. This is something I was told not to talk about. What? Not to talk about? By whom? Huh? You mean it wasn't Edward that told me not to talk? This song is great. Totally agree. Well, testify. My lips were sealed. What in the goddamn is happening right now? Global Studios wanted me to keep quiet about something. There were some other people at the studios on the day of the murder. Oh my god. They said they had nothing to do with it, see? So they told me just to pretend they hadn't been in the studios that day. But if they're gonna go accusing me, I'm not letting them get away scot-free. Ms. Oldbag. This is crucial information. Why did you keep this from the court until now? Ain't you been listening? They told me to shut my trap and I always do what I'm told. No, this isn't a bad dream, Your Honor. Witness the power of the old bag. Can we get her for perjury? Lying under oath? Mr. Wright, your cross-examination. Not really perjury, but... Or is it perjury? I always forget that. I always forget the definition. Anyway. Okay, this is fascinating. Detail, please. So you were told not to talk. That's right, by the studio and the TV bigwigs, no less. Why didn't I hear about this? Don't be too hard on yourself, Sonny. We were all in on it. Okay. There were... This is the second time, too. Oh, you mean the detail that you asked me about already. Yeah, I know I said I was sure about it, but actually... Okay. Detail, please. Who were these people? Well, the director and the producer, for starters. The director? Should have known something was fishy. How could they have done a run-through of their action scene without a director? Of course. Yeah, well, I was surprised no one asked about it. So where were these people? Okay. Director's in the employee area all morning for the run-through. Okay. He joined the producer around lunchtime and had a meeting after that. So they had a meeting. Where? Oh, in the Studio 2 trailer. Studio 2? It was blocked out by the tree, though. Look at the guide map. Here it is. You go through the gate and all the way to the left. The path of the monkey's head was fallen over? Well, Mr. Wright, we're good to continue the cross-examination. Yeah. Nothing to do with it. Yo, what's up, Curry? Oh man, this has been an exhausting trial so far. This is like our third consecutive. Oops, I left out extremely critical information in a row from Ms. Oldbag. So we have just found out that there were more people on the scene than we first thought, which is delightful. Ms. Oldbag, this is the trial for murder. I know that's silly. Still, they were pretty convincing about having nothing to do with it. And they gave me a little bonus on the side. They bribed you and you didn't admit that yet? So you got your bonus and you still talked. Huh. Okay. Yeah, I guess we're good then. Well, one more. Okay. So they were actually in the studio. Yep, the whole day. They heard about the murder, they beat it before the cops came. I'll kill this woman, I swear it. I feel sorry for Edgeworth, almost. She really left him hanging on this one. Okay. What? Oh, okay. Okay. Them? Who were these people? Well, okay, director, producer, okay. Yeah, okay, we're good now. Okay, yep, sorry for the rapid speed, but I don't know why we couldn't just exit from there. No, we're good. Your Honor, we have learned there were others at Global Studios on the day in question. The director and the producer and, some bigwigs were all present. But yet, as we stand here, they have not been questioned. I hold that it is impossible to declare a verdict on the defendant, Mr. Powers. We've only seen Edgeworth so far, but I don't know. I'm assuming there's others at some point, but my guess is that we're going to face Edgeworth in most of them. The court acknowledges that events at this point, the prosecution will gather more information about the witness, Ms. Oldbag, and more information about these other people we've just been told of. Edgeworth seething. I understand, Your Honor. The sentence of the day is proceeding in the trial of Mr. Will Powers. That is all. This court is adjourned. Bonk. Alright. Thank you so much, Mr. Wright. It's super fun. Like, as much as you know, like, it is like a very silly, it's an extremely silly game in terms of, like, you know, the legal proceedings, that makes it such a fun playthrough. Like, it is just such a good time to see, like, each twist happening. There's just, like, 50 in each case so far. I was right to ask you to defend me. Oh, really? It's nothing. Oh, or should I? We'll be going down to the city to do some more investigating. We have to find out more about this director and producer. They'll be turning up in the next trial as witnesses for certain. And now's my chance to get material for the Crox's cross-contamination. So, Nick, have we figured out just who it was in that Steel Samurai costume? Could it really have been old Windbag? What do you think, Mr. Powers? I don't think it was her, really. Neither do I, Nick. Yeah, I know. Look, I was just buying time back there. Someone had to be the bad guy for to take the pressure off Mr. Powers. Poor old Windbag. I feel kind of sorry for her. Well, she wasn't winning any points in there with or without my accusation. Okay, let's get down to the studios. Right. Back to visit you soon. Thanks. Thanks, guys. To be continued. Okay, trial done. Feels good. All right, if you're watching on the stream, don't move. If you're watching YouTube, though, thank you so much for being here. Hopefully you enjoyed the episode. If you did, consider subscribing below to find more content from me, including the playlist above, which is full of the rest of the playthrough. So you can check that out for the rest of the Ace Attorney 1 and probably just one. I'll probably do just separate playthroughs for each game. And hopefully we'll see you live on the stream. I stream Sunday to Thursday, 7 p.m. Eastern at twitch.tv/SL_TVs. Hopefully we'll see you live. Come join us. Hang out. Until next time. Peace.